things we humans pay most attention to is other people's faces. We love faces. They're the first thing we like to look at when we're born, and we see them everywhere, even in places where they don't really exist. Like on a bin, or in a vegetable, or on a mince pie. These are just a few photos I've taken recently of places I've seen a face, but there are hundreds more on the internet. We have to pay attention to faces. We're a social species, so reading other people's feelings is really important for us. So we've evolved to look out for any patterns that might be a face. And it's better to see one where there isn't one than to miss noticing someone who might be a friend or a foe. So sometimes our amazing ability to detect patterns goes too far, leading us to see faces and other patterns where there are none. Faces are just one example of a pattern that we're good at spotting. In fact, brain scanning studies have found that when looking at different board layouts, chess grandmasters activate the same brain region that most of us use to recognise faces. This suggests that we could all become experts in whatever types of pattern we choose. It's just that for most of us, faces are the most important patterns of all. But this also means that faces are the thing we have the most expectations about. Have a look at these images. Do you recognise them? Does anything look strange? How about now? We don't see upside down faces very often, so we don't have a good idea in our heads of what they look like. When looking at this picture, you register that the eyes, nose and mouth are in the right place and just assume that it's a normal face turned upside down. You're using your knowledge of what a face should look like rather than bothering to look at the details. It's only when we turn it the right way up that it becomes so obviously different from a normal face and the upside down mouth and eyes jump out at you. Here's another example. This is a hollow model of an ape's face. It's the sort of thing that might be used as a mask. Now watch carefully as I rotate the mask. Hopefully, you'll see something strange happen. What most people see during this illusion is that at some point during the rotation, the face appears to pop out, so it's sticking forwards like a normal face, and starts rotating in the opposite direction. But don't worry if you don't see it. Everyone's brain is a little bit different, and not everyone sees every illusion. So what is going on here? Well, as is the case much of the time when we're looking at something, the clues your brain was getting were ambiguous. Once you can no longer see the side of the mask, it could be light falling on a hollow mask rotating clockwise, or light falling on a normal face rotating anti-clockwise. So your brain makes a guess, using your past knowledge of faces. You've seen thousands of faces throughout your life, and hopefully the vast majority stuck out. So your brain decides that that's the most likely scenario, and that's what you see. This is known, unsurprisingly, as the hollow mask illusion, and it's been found in infants as young as 6 months old. It tells us a lot about how our brains use their past experience to make sense of the world around us, which I think is pretty amazing. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions about the hollow mask or other illusions, or ideas for future episodes, comment below. And if you know someone you think would like this video, please do share it. And of course, hit like and subscribe for more videos about your amazing brain. If you'd like to find out about another sense and how we can trick it, why not try this video on our sixth sense, proprioception. See you soon, and until then, stay curious.